स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द क्लाउड डिप्लॉयमेंट मॉडल. इन दैट द टाइप ऑफ क्लाउड, फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट द प्राइवेट क्लाउड. व्हाट इज प्राइवेट क्लाउड एंड हाउ वी कैन कॉन्फिगर डिप्लॉय द रिसोर्सेज ऑन अ प्राइवेट क्लाउड एंड व्हाट इज द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ द private cloud. In today's class we are going to discuss about the public cloud. It is another type of cloud deployment model. Since public itself is defining that it is accessible to any user. In previous class, as we discuss about the private cloud, and we discussed that we have a client server architecture, and we are not talking about the client because we only need the browser and we need the internet. We are talking about the server. In a traditional client server architecture, we have a single server, dedicated server for a single dedicated application. But when we talk about the public cloud or cloud computing concept, this server is now changed. This server is basically collection of various physical resources, the data centers which are capable of storing the huge amount of data, the workstations that is capable to perform the various complex computational tasks, also the virtual machines which are used for virtualization of the various resources, so that n number of customers, cloud users, can register for request for the various services of the cloud, and these virtual machines can fulfill the requirement of any number of cloud users. So we are talking about that server level configuration, and that is known as cloud deployment model. So in public cloud, a public cloud is built over the internet and can be accessed by any users who has paid for the services. The cloud infrastructure is made available to the general public or a large industry group to provide cloud services. The cloud is owned by an organizations, or we can say cloud service providers, that is selling the cloud services and are accessible through subscriptions. So public cloud may be managed by the third party providers. There are so many public clouds are available today. These are Google App Engines, GAE, AWS, Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure, IBM's Blue Cloud, and Salesforce.com's Force.com. The providers of the aforementioned clouds are commercial providers that offers publicly accessible remote interface for creating and managing the virtual machines instances within their proprietary infrastructures. Basically, a public cloud delivers a selected set of business processes. The applications and infrastructure services are offered on flexible price per use basis. Basically, public clouds are operated at data centers owned by a service vendor that uses dynamic provisionings, implement scalable service platforms, and pay per use licensing model is used. Economically, public cloud service provide effective cost saving to an consumer. Vendor provide low cost services because of shared hardware infrastructure and resource pooling capabilities. The public cloud implementation removes maintenance burden from an organization with shared resources, remote hosting, and dynamic licensing of cloud. In public cloud, depending upon a customer's need of customized configuration requirements and service level agreements SLA, vendors dynamically and automatically provide the cloud services to its customer. The large scale infrastructures and virtualization of resources provide scalability, on-demand availability, and compliances with the SLAs. An example of public cloud service is your Google's email, that is the Gmail service, which is bundled with more service like Google Drive, Google Docs, Google Plus, and many more services provided by Google. There are various benefits of using the public cloud. Since it is public cloud managed by the cloud service provider or third party vendors, it has shared infrastructure, resource poolings. Another benefit is low cost service based on pay per use model. Another benefit is no burden of maintenance of IT infrastructure, ubiquitous availability of the cloud services. Some services are available free of cost, and many vendors providing the services free of cost, like we can say Google Drive, Google Docs. These are the facilities provided by Google, which is free of cost if we are not purchasing it as a business or commercial. There is dynamic provisioning and scalability on demand. So in future, the number of users or customer increases, or also any customer want to expand their business and requires more number of resources, then it can be scalable in public cloud. Availability of high standard world class tools. Since it is a public cloud managed by the third party vendors, so up to date tools are available in the public cloud. Since the public cloud have lots of advantages or benefits, it has some drawbacks also. Since it is a public cloud, so it may possible that there is no control on data and process, and the privacy of data is not assured in case of service denial due to security attack or data theft by hackers. The public cloud is the services of public cloud solely depend on the internet. So if availability of internet is affected, then customer will not be able to get cloud services. Thank you.